might have to catch the boat. He said we can catch the boat. The University of Tampa's over there. Captain Larry, they can take us by boat. So I think I might be on the boat, bitch.
With flipping flops.
Yeah, I'm on the boat. I'm gonna go to the car, might park it. I don't know, we might get something to eat first. Cause this is one of the places where you park and your car be underneath the hotel somewhere. So we might get grab something to eat, come back, chill out, relax, watch some ESPN, and then go to the show. See how this whole boat thing works out. I like to take my own vehicle to the shows. You know, it might go down. You might have to slap somebody and pull off. But you never know. We'll see what's up. Gary Owens is the one who showed me about that college stuff. He is about that college life. He the first person to say, your set is not a club set. You, a young guy, you need to do these colleges. This was when I was first starting doing comedy. And I wasn't ready for the college set either. I wasn't ready for that, but when he told me, because I want to do it, but it's not a game. When you get to these schools, if you can't do an hour, you need to sit your head down somewhere because they will call your agent and complain, and then your name will get out around the reputation. Like a lot of these, I've seen a couple of y'all shows in the colleges. Y'all ain't ready. You know what I'm saying? Simple as that. Some people got a good 15, some people got a hot 20, maybe a hot 30. You got to be up there good for 60 minutes, period. And y'all can write all the hate comments you want to. Facts is the fact. These are the custom Air Ronnie flyers I give out to the shows and sign for the kids. Got my stats on them, my Twitter, Instagram. If they don't know how to find you, how they gonna find you? And I also sell my DVDs at the schools. See, the trick is a lot of comedians say they don't buy DVDs at colleges. They do. You gotta drop the price. See, most dudes want $10 for a DVD. I charge $5. And I got something else that if you ain't up on this, you need to quit comedy. You know what I'm saying? If you ain't got you one of these, that square, if you don't know what this is the square. You put this shit in, put this ish, I'm sorry. Swipe your credit card, boom. It's in my bank account the next day. So, you know, step your hustle up, step your comedy grind up. This is $10 at Target. Or if you go to Square, you download the Square app, and they'll send you one for free, and they charge like 0.2% or something. So since I charge $5 for a DVD, if somebody uses their credit card, I charge them $6. I charge them $6, and then $5.82 goes in my account every person. So, you know, that adds up. So when I go to these colleges, you know, I'm slanging them. You know what I'm saying? Like, and you have these, you make these the same thing, so you can, if they don't have no money at the time, they're going to try to get some money and go to your site. That's if you did a good show. So that's some of my comedy hustle. Let me sit down in the boss chair.
I'm Lauren from the University of Tampa. I'm the stage show's chair, First Unit Productions. And my organization went to NACA South this past fall, came back and told me about all the awesome comedians they had seen, and Ronnie Jordan was like number one on their list, and they were like, you need to have them, him. Brought him to my committee. My committee was obsessed, and we had to bring him, and I'm so glad that we were able to bring him to school this semester, and I really think everyone who's here really enjoyed him.
Well, yeah, man, when I first started, I was back home, had dropped out of school, didn't know what I was going to do, but I just know I like doing the open mics, had it been done about 3 or 4, and I just know I wanted to do this, but I used to get so much backlash from my parents. It was like, when you going to get back to school? When you going to do this? My little brother was like, you done dropped out of school and everything, and this and that, and I was like, I'm going to do something. And I finally moved in with my manager at the time, Kelsey. I was on a full-time, man, telling jokes, you know what I'm saying? And then just to come to something like this is pretty cool, man. You know, even, like last week we was at a Harbor Hotel, so we just appreciate a good, this is Sheraton. So if you got enough points, you can live like this. This ain't nothing too extravagant, but it's nice, you know, it's tranquil. You come out here and smoke your drugs if you like, but they gonna tell on you.
Back to the job, back to the V103 building in Atlanta. People think I'm going
When they said, I said, I'm going back to Atlanta. I said, I'm going home. I ain't going home. Back to work. Pick me up.
I'm on the road, doing shows, traveling in and out of town. Tour buses, G4s, gonna be hard to slow me down. I refuse to slow down.
It was slow though, then it sped up.
Man, that money comes so fast, I don't know if it's gonna land. I should probably hit the brakes, but instead I hit the gas. First place, motherfuck the last. It's all about the win, who gives a fuck who cares?